So this is kind of a mod from the original Settlers 2, 15-year-old game almost, but it's an awesome game. It's a base building, town building, and logistics manager, and a little bit more strategy, fights. I love it, and I hope you like it too. Here you go then. Join Return to the Roots. I'll keep the link on the description, but down below here you can see Settlers25.org. It's easy to download. You just need to buy the original game from Ubisoft, but it's probably very cheap by now. Okay, let's go. Play replay. I think is the first one. Yes. Here. Oh no no. This is the replay I tried to cast already. You know what? Let's do this again. Start with this one. Let's go. I'm gonna present everything about this game. Or maybe not. Just going to record everything as we go. So, let's make the map. Here is what this little player here can see. His name is Spike. Using the Babylonians, if I'm not mistaken. And for every building that you build, most of them, you need tools. Those are the tools, and some of the workers that have the tool already and are designed to be the specific worker, they are here already. The huntsman, he needs a bow, but he already has his bow, so he's here to be a huntsman. As for settlers that only carry things from one flight to the other, those are infinite. You can have as many as you want. In this game, in this particular match, you have very little resources to begin with, very little planks and stones to make the buildings, and not many tools either. So you have to be very careful with your first buildings, and it's a guarantee to have a somewhat slow start. Spike here is already making a sawmill to convert its logs into boards, and it's quite slow, but he can't make another sawmill right now because there is no other saw, so neither another carpenter that uses that tool, so we have to stick with that. To make more tools, you need this, an iron smelter that uses the iron ore and the coal to make an iron bar. Then use this iron bar on the toolsmith, or how you can call it, an metalwork that uses the iron bar with a plank to make a tool. On the armory, use the iron bar with coal to make a weapon. And he also has the mint that use coal with gold to make gold coins, which improve your soldiers little by little, but they can get really big. They have the small soldier ranking here, but every gold coin improves one soldier one rank further up, and this one is much better than a soldier. More hit points, and he lays down every hit much better. Okay, now he's building a metalwork, and here you can see a forester to plant trees, two woodcutters, another woodcutter here. And here a quarry to get the stones. Okay. Oh, here we have another sawmill. Now he can do that. Let's see. Oh, here you can see he can build each kind of building. The castles, you can make a farm. It's the base for most of the food, pig farm, and a docking breeding. Dockies help to carry things. But I'm going to see. Oh yes, here you go in tools, and you see you can control what tool do you want to be produced. We are on a replay, so I can't actually control that. But it's already everything set for the first tool to be built to be a saw. Here we have the metalwork, already three iron bars. Another one. The iron smelter should have produced another one. There it is, four iron bars. He is out of coal and iron ore, and we'll need to mine more coal and iron ore. And that you can only do in the mountains. There are no mountains nearby. For the mining to work, they need food. And to make food, you need all sorts of things. And that's kind of the cycle. You make things to make the buildings, and for the buildings to work you need tools, and for the soldiers you need armor, and for that you need iron, coal and gold, and for that you need food, and for that you need buildings. And for the buildings you need tools. And so it goes. Now the beauty of it, it's how you lay down every building and make the paths for the logistics. And in this particular game, maybe most of multiplayer games are like this. You have to know which tool to produce in the beginning, with so little resources to start. You don't have much wood production either, so you have to make the buildings very carefully planned. Okay, so it seems that I was speaking so boringly that the mic just decided to shut itself off. Just decided to die. So I just didn't have any audio recorded for the next 50 minutes or so. So on this replay that I'm recording that I was recording for the second time already. So now I'm recording at least the audio for a third time. Let me just check if everything is going right. Oh, I think it is. Yes, I saw some peaks on the audio. Yes, it is going right. I hope so. If not, this replay, it's the last try. I bought a new headset, a new microphone, so I won't have this kind of problem anymore, hopefully, for a very long time. But since I started this recording with this microphone, I won't change it just yet. People had... Oh, just... And now I'm starting to look on other people. Here is Double Fire with a very impressive wide start, but this won't get you anywhere later in the game because you need the tools, you need to produce more wood. And he just didn't. So he will be kinda of a stall for now. On the first time I recorded this game, I was so impressed and wishing from him. I thought he was going to be the one to beat on this game. But as you see, it won't. Nah. Okay, so where was I? Oh yes, I'm really happy to say that the second game that I recorded, which was the first one that I uploaded because of this little audio problem, had some nice feedback, even if it was on a rather slow spanning map. Expanding from as for expansion, but still people like it, and I already got 4 new replays, actually 3 because 2 are from the same game, but yes, 3 new replays from no one else but Spike, which plays an awesome game. It's really fun to watch. He's I learned that he seems to be the one behind Return to the Roots uploading streams. He is the one behind Return to the Roots mode. He is the one making changes, and he even launches an update on YouTube, update with all the new changes for each new build. That's really cool. Here we see Kaiser Chief with a kind of different approach. He's not expanding very fast. Decided to do other things first, like it's the usually good strategy for this kind of game. And he is going for 3 sawmills instead of 2, which may bite him in the long run or may not. Spike, for once, is making only 2 sawmills until he reaches the mines and is able to make another saw. He used only 1 of his 4 iron bars to make a saw. Kaiser Chief used 2. It won't make a really huge difference, but yeah, because Spike won't run out of wood in this game. He is just placing buildings carefully and wisely, and he just don't run out of wood. by the time he has to build a lot of things like farms and a lot of iron smelters, he already have a third saw. Still here, Kaiser Chief only with three headquarters, only with on the headquarter only four stored woods, planks, boards, you name it, only four boards. That's the name of the game. But he's already building something which seems to be a farm down there. So a lot of boards will go out. I may be talking about, yes, I was talking about the food chain. You make the farm to start almost all the food, besides the meat that you can hunt with the hunter, and the fish that you can only fish on the sea. You cannot grow them on, I don't know the name, on a building that grows fishes, not in this game. And the other, you can also make meat by building a pig farm and providing it with the wheat and water. Then you make a pig and you go and make a slaughterhouse to transform that pig into meat. Yeah, that's it. Unfortunately, poor pig. And you can also make breads by making a mill to make flour and the bakery. And there you saw the beer and water. That's the other resource you need wheat for. To recruit soldiers, you need beer. Besides the shield and the sword, you need beer. Yes, that's a fun thing on this game. Very, very German looking. So that's the wheat chain. And to make farms are really expensive. And now my cell phone, that he put on silent. Okay, nothing important anyway. Sorry for that. Here we are back now on Kaiser Chief. He has now a fortress. He could reach the mountains, but he's not mining anything. He could got out of his stalling, but still not Kaiser Chief. That's, I don't know what I said about which player was, but that was Double Fire. We were watching Kaiser Chief just before that. Now it's Spike. He still not haven't reached the mountains and is making two farms already, even using only two sawmills. That headquarters over there, I think it's from Kaiser Chief. 10 planks and 3 stones, I think. Can check that out right now. Warzone here with a nice looking base and a different starting approach. Yes, that's the word I was looking for. He's making more fortresses than smaller buildings. It's a rather slow expansion and sometimes expensive, especially for stones, as stones are not an infinite resource and sometimes you have to watch it. On this map you kinda have a lot of stones for the size of it, but still you need to get them. Only now Only 6 stones stored in the headquarters. If I'm watching right. No, I'm not. Yeah, he also has 3 sawmills. And is way further, much further away from the mountains where he can get mines than spikies or double fire. And Kaiser Chief a little. There is one more player here on this game, which is KGB. We probably will get to him in a while. He is looking strong, man. Let me tell you that. But he will have one problem in this game, which is he won't find any gold until it's kinda late and in a bad position, bad spot. But he was expanding like a madman. And there you see the how you produce the roads, a nice solution, making everything hexagonal. There is KGB, look out how big he is already, kind of like double fire with lasers. a little something else, making a storehouse there. He has got to the mountains on the east and on the bottom. A nice solution here, 3 foresters. No, that's not a woodcutter. This is a woodcutter. Has 3 woodcutters and 3 foresters. I think each forester supplies trees for 2 woodcutters, so he's rather stalling but made a nice forest near the starting spot. And this also makes animals. It's a nice way to make some meat from the hunter. There is one hunter, that small hut near the headquarters. I think that's the hunter. Here we're having, he's building already a storehouse and has already mines, a coal mine and an iron mine. It's pretty much ahead of everybody into that sense, I think so. Don't know how the other people are doing right now, but and a fortress there. Now that's a good place to make a fortress, I think so. Because you can't expand, can't build any buildings other than mines on the mountain. So you need a fortress to expand your area as much as possible into the mountains. Not only because it's a rather very strategic spot. That's just the other thing. And on this side, yes, still not making any mines. And here you see Spikey, he doesn't have mines yet, but just order to be built. He also has a fortress near the mines, and now he's building a lot of things. Storehouse, made a little mistake there building 2 storehouses. It will take a while for him to notice. The storehouse will be almost completed, I think, if I'm not mistaken. Yes, even in a small map like this one, where you don't have a lot of resources, you still make mistakes managing having to manage a lot of things. It's so much easier to watch on the replay. Yes, I just played an online game, as you may have seen on the videos I have sent, and I was watching the replay later on, and it was a torture for me seeing some mistakes, especially in logistics, and not being able to do anything, scratching my head. Oh man, that's really a torture. I still need to learn find a very good video format for me to record a little more videos, because it takes a lot of space and later on some work and a lot of video processing, because I don't have a very good uploading speed. I have to process the video as much as I can without losing the quality. So a video that lasts 1 hour long takes 6 hours to be processed, even in my computer, which is has an Intel Core i7 processor, just because of that. Yes. Yeah, it could take only half of that time or even faster without compressing a lot more, but I like it that way. I may change it in the future. Yes, just because of a 10% space size, maybe. But let's keep it that way right now. And here we see a nice road near the headquarters and other buildings. Kaiser Chief spanning a little bit slower, but very solid, making most of the space he has already and making a fortress somewhat near the mine. Yes, there are the mountains. And what building is he building right there? I think it's a farm. You could start maybe building the iron smelter and the other buildings already, if you have the resources. Yes, fortress already have everything, so you could just build the storehouse and all the other buildings. Maybe just to speed things up a little bit. In the sawmill here. Oh, I just wanted to see the star house. 2 planks, and here 20. Yes, a lot of wood. He could just build up. He's just missing some stones though. Oh, they're probably going into the first star house, which is near the quarry. And here we see Spike. The mighty Spike. Destroying the smelter and the ironworks, because now he has them near the mountains, as you see here. And the mine's already done. 1 iron and 1 of the coal from coal. In this game, which you have very few resources to start with. Oh, now you can also see the full map ahead, so you can compare them, each one of them, using the minimap. Kaiser Chief is still away from the mountains. He's the most behind one into this matter. What was I saying? Yes, you can't build a lot of mines at the beginning of this match, because you probably don't have many pickaxes or miners which already have the tool in the beginning. So everything you have to build: the tongue for the metalwork, the the plate, kind of plate for the iron smelter, for the mint which makes the gold coins, and the pickaxes for the miners, and the tools for the farmer and everything else. Yes. Everything you has to be very well thought, very well think it through. I can't wait to play a game like this. Probably gonna be a mess in the beginning, the first time I try it. Oh man, oh boy. We'll be together. Probably I want to record every game I play online, just as I am playing. But yeah, it will be fun. While it is fun, I think it's fun. I think I'm having fun. I think you're having fun watching. At least I think I'm having fun. You may be bored, but yeah, I will try to record everything. It's not like get to replay later on and talk through, because some things you are thinking only as you go. Later on, you see that was a fail plan, but it's at that moment, maybe it wasn't. I hope you understand what I'm saying, what I mean. So that was KGB, I think. I don't know really how he's doing right now. Wasn't paying a lot of attention. I think he was doing alright. And glad to see that the audio is still recording. I can see on the bars in the video editor. Wait. Every time I'm moving the chair, I'm afraid losing the audio. But that day I wasn't only moving the chair, I was changing the wire position from the front to the back and to the side and everything. Not use it just to sit and watch and talking. Yeah. Funny thing, when I played the game, I didn't move a single bit. I was really, really focused with my head almost with my nose near the screen or very close. Now I'm just relaxing in my chair. Yeah, sorry if I'm talking a lot about myself right now. I should be casting the game. But yeah, let's just do it how we can. Spike just making another set of mines, of iron mine and coal mine. I wonder how much food does he have right now to provide those mines. And double fire here just won't go anywhere now. It's not even building mines. But he must be enjoying himself. This game is, when you're starting to play it, you play like this, really slow, but enjoying everything, every bit of it. Because that's your own making. Just a little harder to be good on online game like that, but if you're having fun, that's alright. You have to start at some point, right? And what's this? I can't talk with them on the replay. It would be fun if I could. So, Kaiser Chief. Now has just made a fortress there, has a lot of new areas to expand. In fact, 3 fortresses and 1 watchtower. Man, that's expensive. And there's the mine. One of them was built, but isn't connected. Because it's probably has intention to use the only pickaxe that the other pickaxe that he have in the iron mine. He needs iron to make another pickaxe. Otherwise, if the miner gets into that mine, he probably will have to destroy it to get the miner out and to make him go into the iron mine. Still having a hard time trying to find iron, as he can't see a lot of into the mountains. But he could send the geologists a little bit to the right and to the left already. Sending the geologists something. Yes, I'm getting lazy just thinking of it. You have to build the flag and click on the flag again and then send the geologist. It will be nice to have a shortcut key that you just click with the mouse and the geologist go that way, pressing that key. Something to think about. Yeah, maybe a geologist button in the interface. Same for the scout. But the interface is kinda clean like this. I don't know. There are some games that have such a messy interface. In that sense. How far are we into the replay? 38 minutes. Yes. Still a lot to record and to talk about. So, there was a brewery there. A lot of trees, not much wheat. One thing that you have in the beginning of this game are when you have the mines, you finally got to the mines, you already have some food in the headquarters. Store it. That was what I was looking for. And there I'm trying to find out the houses. That's the iron smelter. I can't find the iron smelter. And that building. Yes, there it is, the iron smelter. Very nice, very beautiful building set. This one, I don't know if it's... I'm tempted to say that's from the Japanese. I like it because it fits into this world near the nature, the outside of town. It looks nice. I wonder if there was a German tribe, how the buildings will look like, all white with red roofs. Yeah, okay. So, here we see double fire, no, KGB. With 2 mindsets, kinda like spike, but not making a lot of buildings to use that. He has 2 iron smelters already. Now that's good, but only 1 armory. I don't know, I think you can have 2 armories. Maybe now he's just making a lot of tools in the toolsmith, so he won't be able to use 2 armories right now. Yeah, that could be the reason for it. You need the tools to make to expand your food production in order to expand your mining capabilities in order to make 2 armories and still keep the toolsmith going. And when you start making gold coins, you will need 3 coal mines. That gets... Oh, you may need coal mines now, because you need coal for the iron smelter and for the armory. Yes. Big, big problem. Thank God the toolsmith doesn't use any coal. We have a lot of trouble like this already. Amazing how casting wears you out. I need to eat something sweet. There it is. I'm sorry if this is gonna make you some noises, but I need it. Need some sugar. Here you see Spike now has a really nice production going. If I was his enemy and I saw this in this game, I would be scared. Making a 4th coal mine? Or is that the 3rd one? I think it's the 3rd one. Really impressive. Oh, check out how many flags in Kaiser Chiefs base. He won't suffer from any logistics problem. No, no. In Saturn's games, the funniest thing is sometimes is watch the logistics and you have to squeeze something through smaller ways. Like this is, I don't know. Once I made a game on a big map and I produced only 1 boat so I could see everything that's being transported overseas. And also to be kind of a challenge, if I could beat the AI with only 1 boat. That was in the 10th anniversary, so my harbors couldn't be attacked. So it was way easier to have only 1 boat. this country seems like it has two towns, one near the headquarters with two buildings, and then the other one. And I'm using my mouse there to show that he could make a nice diagonal path straight there in front of all those buildings. It's just there ready to be built. He probably don't want to do it because he is saving those spots for the buildings later on. Yeah, if you produce a lot of farms, you need space to the mill, the bakeries, slaughterhouse, the pig farm. And the base gets much smaller than it was. There we see a farm being built, and here you can see all that Kaiser Chief is actually being able to watch. You're closed down into your own world when you're playing online, and you can only guess how you're doing by the statistics when you can see the other statistics. I still think that's kind of a cheat. I like to see a game that you just can't see any statistics, and I'm trying to stay away from them in the replay because they just tell too much of the game. It's rather fun to have some mystery. Until I can't hold myself and just take a peek, because yeah, I'm just curious. Kaiser Chief still can't see, cannot see the border of the enemy, even though they're so close. Warzone, right there. In this map, you can get to the enemy by the stones or through the mountains. If a player here wanted to get to the player already, to the other enemy, he probably would have to make barracks or guardhouses, expanding non-stop. If you have the wood and the other resources, you probably will be knocking at his base down below. Kaiser Chief there is here on the minimap. He's already way into the mountain, and he is only making fortresses. There you see, he's already down below. And fortresses are way, way slower to expand. He still hasn't found any gold. Let me see something here. At what minute mark the audio returns? Yeah, it will take a long time. Still. Let's keep it going. Mm-hmm. So where are we? Still only one armory. I like to see His pathways are more organic-like. It's beautiful this way. And still a lot of stones together. He just isn't making much carries, is he? Well, I wonder how many quarries you can build with the starting resources. Slowly, slowly destroy the stone. One could make a lot of pickaxes and get the stones near the enemy to get into the enemy, but he probably will have to spend the resources making the pickaxes instead of making swords and shields, and then he'll lose because of that. If the enemy is a close match, if the enemy is stronger, he will lose anyway. If he's weaker, well, you guess. Here, check out how different the base on Spike. I think KGB still has the toolsmith and the iron smelter near the base. I don't know what Todd was looking up there. I think that was from Quarzone or KGB. Few mills there. This is Quarzone base expanding really nice. He has a second set of woodcutters and maybe a forester there. But there are the three carries, and you can see no stones in the middle of his base. And you can see the farm house still unoccupied. He just built the farms but need to produce the shites right now. He has some nice mining going on. 3 coal mines and 2 iron. Just look at the settlers leaving all the carrying all the resources back to the base where the iron smelter and the armory are. Sometimes it's a good thing to keep them near the base. I sometimes keep the mint near my headquarters just so that they bring out the gold and coal already near to my base, because the mines sometimes are in a dangerous spot and I don't want to lose everything. Yeah, if you have a storehouse near the mines and the iron processing plant and everything, sometimes it's better to ask the storehouse not to store the final product because they are very expensive and finite. They just end, you know. So Kaiser Chief, now once he got to the mountain, he's producing a nice base there. Here also found some gold there, really nice. 4 coal mines, all them connected to the network, so gathering food and producing coal. He probably doesn't have enough food right now to make the mines produce at 100%, but at least he has already a lot of coal and is producing in proportion. If you want you can adjust, but it's nice to have a lot of mines once you have the food. But yeah, you could use the tools to make food buildings instead of mine buildings already. Yeah, so I don't know. And Double Fire finally made a mine. Yeah, he not only stuck it up, he's just making everything rather slowly after the very fast start. There is a farm, a pig farm nearby, and the slaughterhouse, the whole chain. And there's a quarry near the watchtower. Yeah, I just need a more practice. He has everything there. He's going to. A lot of pets are now near the mines to avoid any traffic jam. Is it traffic jam? Something jam. Maybe it's just to avoid jam. Goods jam. Stuff being carried. And that was the slider to adjust how much food goes into each kind of mine. Sometimes that just doesn't work. For the 70th anniversary, the gold seems to receive all the food. Or maybe it's because when you adjust the slider, it only the new food that's being produced will suffer that new adjustment, so it takes sometimes a long time to everything change as you order it. I was always looking for the coal mines, and there is just not food here. Am I not producing enough food? And then I looked into the gold mine, and there it was full of food and still producing. It wasn't because the mine was exhausted. It just pissed me off. Sometimes I started to close down the production in the gold mine. There's the iron smelter, it's melting away. He has now 3 iron smelters, I think so. Yes. The other building looks like is the armory. Maybe 2 armories. I know that there is a brewery somewhere there. I think it's the one near the fortress. There is one building I just can't recognize right now. Oh, I think it's the bakery. It's right near the mouse. The one with a big cylinder on the side, near the armory. Here another place that Spike is producing wood. I'm not sure if he needs any more wood production. But he's doing anyway. Well, for the amount of farms that he's going to build, maybe that's just what he needs. If I could click, I would click now on the headquarters just to see how many woods he has in store. Check out how many farms. Yes. In this game, if you think you have too much farms already, just build twice as that. Yeah. Just like that. It's that crazy. And look out the star house, the fortress, already near the base from KGB. Attack imminent. Somewhat. He still can't reach anything right there. I think so. As for generals. And he's going to build another fortress, and there's a catapult and a lookout tower. As you see, he can't see much further ahead. He just now saw where KGB is. KGB doesn't have a lot of gold, so he's a little bit behind in the military. Now he's finally mining some gold. Check out where he found gold. There. And on the bottom there. That mining spot. Had to go all the way to find gold. I wonder if he could find something here or the other places. Just unfortunate. Just unlucky. Maybe there was gold there. I don't know if he spotted all the places he could. And he could go a little bit further to the right there. Never expanded into that direction. Near the quarry. It's not like he was going to be attacked anyway. The place is blocked by the stones. At least he could scout right here. He's very close to Spike. And now trying to build a fortress before Spike does. On the other side here, Kaiser Chiefs not expanding much to the north. He's staying away from Spike. Warzone not close enough to Kaiser Chief, and KGB and Warzone almost barely touching each other. So it's just about every place we have everyone starting to get together at the same time. There's a nice looking lookout tower. Yes, that's the name. A nice looking lookout tower. And this is what each one of those can see. There you see the lookout tower. Nice. Not only reveals the map, as it keeps you all from having fog of war. And there it goes, the two armies going to attack, and KGB destroyed the building just when the armies were getting there. That was close. You probably saw the news on the news place, and got there just in time. A shame, because it just was going to occupy the fortress. But I don't know if it's a real shame, because he's just running away from every battle. Maybe he could win, but only with private soldiers against a general. I don't know, man. So how are we doing right now? Yeah, he's making another fortress. Yeah, the battle is going to wait a little bit now. Still, Spike can't see that KGB has gold right there. I wonder if he will change anything. Knowing that. Spiky. Saying something about KGB, away from him running away, but I don't know. It may be. And there's a star house with a fortress. It's a good thing to have a star house near the military buildings, as the soldiers can just stay there waiting. Warzone with a nice looking base right now, a lot of farms. I think that he's the second one with the biggest number of farms. Some just not occupied right now. But it's a nice looking base still. Yeah, Kaiser Chiefs also doing rather nice. Man, I wanna play online against those guys. I probably do great on the economic stuff, or somewhat nice, but the military, there are a lot of tricks, chips and tricks, or I don't know the word, but it's something you have to learn playing. Like keeping an eye to see what soldiers occupied each building and that sort of thing. Deciding when to attack and when not to attack. That's hard, man. The decisions in this game on the military, the decision to attack or not, it's big. Oh, and there is the slaughterhouse without a butcher. Oh boy. Yeah, I wonder what Doublefire has in mind now to get out of that mess. He probably doesn't know about the iron smelter and the metalworks or something like that. You need to plan, man. You need to plan everything. On this game with no resources. Let me just... We are almost there. Yeah. Just in a while, it's time to send you back to my younger self, 1 week or 10 days earlier. And I'm finally through with this game. I think I will be. Just need to edit the audio. The video is already processed. Just need to edit this audio. Render it and edit it and mix with the video. Then I can just leave it uploading. Nice. Then I can cast a new game. Just can't wait. And there you see another time that Spike go into KGB. He just destroyed the fortress to avoid it from being conquered. He could stay and fight, but against four generals he must have thought that he was going to lose, and he was probably right, so he just flew away. And I just don't know what are the rules for this game, the winning conditions, but I know that, yeah, I don't know. If I knew the winning conditions, I could tell if someone has won this game, but they probably just call it a match after a while. Still everybody getting ready for fights everywhere. Just check out how many farms. And then all the generals going away. I wonder if he's trying to occupy that building with something else to make more generals, or why is he running away? I'm not sure. In the military here, you can check his settings. I'm not really familiar with all this. Well, and I also don't know exactly how we can empty on a military building. I think just when you that build button, I something like if the soldiers in that building help in the attack or in the defense, I think. But when you pass the mouse above it, it doesn't say anything, so I was just trying to see. Four quarries there. Warzone has decided to get into Kaiser Chief, which is not really looking forward to it, as he only have one quarry. And there is a fight already. Whoa, I didn't thought they could fight already. They could fight each other. Because the... Oh, you can build a path already. Nice. I was thinking about spike and double fire there, which has a lot of barracks just waiting to be conquered. It's time for me to pass you back to my old self. Or just in a while. The audio is still rather bumpy. I'm hearing myself already. Just big fight there. And okay, let me check if everything's it's dirty. Look at that. All the statues going to the storehouse. And here we have only two soldiers. That's up here. So there they come to occupy those buildings. But why are they going this way? Oh, he's just sending them in that fortress. Just in case there is attack somewhere here. Another building captured. Never mind the fortresses. Maybe he's planning for a counterattack. You can order an attack if you want. If you can attack, if the, someone can attack the other side, you will see in the replay. That's what I mean. That's what I meant. And let me see, Farzon, how are the defenses? Only one soldier here, one here. Yeah, not looking good for me.